Hello and welcome back to Seaside Garage. This time it's a moped video. This moped I actually fixed up a while back, and I haven't made any videos on it, and it's a shame because it's awesome. I got it in pieces together with another moped, and I ended up actually building the engine from the other moped, which was completely trashed, over on this one because the engine on this one was trashed. So it's a Frankenstein engine, where the head is from the old engine because the head got mounts for the frame and the other engine didn't. So I combined it and it works fine. I changed this barrel down here to a new one, alloy one, which is making the moped quite fast actually. But me and my friends are going on a moped trip in a couple of weeks time, and we are planning on doing it more often together because it's a nice way to hang out together, to drive to a forest and make a camp and do silly stuff. But anyway, one of my very good friends is going to own this one and drive this one, and before he picks it up, I would actually like to do something about, at least try to do something about the brakes, because the brakes are extremely poor on this one. It's an old school moped, so the rear brakes are in the pedals, where you press the pedal backwards. That's the braking. And that is done by some shoes inside of the rear wheel. And actually, I think it's lack of lubrication that makes them not work, which maybe doesn't really make sense when you hear it, but they need lubrication to work. I'm going to take the rear wheel off and investigate. The front is drum brakes, like the Puch. It's not braking very efficiently, and another problem is it won't really release the brake after letting go of the brake, which means that it loses top speed, which is very important that it doesn't. So we're going to take a look at that also. I'm going to take both wheels off now and take you back. So this is the front wheel, which is off the moped now. And let's take a look at it. Well, I really wonder why these brakes even worked, but I can understand why they were quite noisy. This is pretty much how it is supposed to look. This is two shoes that push out like this to brake inside inside the drum. It pushes against the inside diameter of the drum by this lever. Maybe I can demonstrate. So this is the braking material. It's a brake pad. This is friction material that leaves a coating of material on the inside of the drum, and then the friction against this material and the leftover material on the drum will break it. But on the other side, this one has fallen off, and inside of here is the rest of it. So this moped needs a set of new brake shoes, and I do believe it's the same as the Puch Maxi one, which is lucky because I have a set of those which needs to go on my Puch Maxi actually, but I can order some new ones. A word of warning, this is an old moped, so this is most likely or could very well be asbestos, so be careful when working on old brakes. I seem to be lucky. These are brake shoes for a Puch Maxi, or at least I ordered them for a Puch Maxi. And they seem to be the exact same dimensions as these on the Mobylette. So yeah, the springs is a bit different, but that wouldn't matter. So let's try to fit them. Well, I could. There we go. Not under as much tension as a car brake, but it's still a bit difficult. Like that. and then this mechanism needs to move freely, and it does. It's completely fine. I'm gonna clean this up, get the dust away, and then put the new ones on. Here we go, it's a bit cleaner. I'm going to lubricate this pivoting point and this, just the sides that touches against the pads. It's just to avoid them getting stuck or having them squeal or something like that. I don't really know if it's actually necessary, but it's necessary on a car at least, unless you want noisy brakes. So I don't think it would do any harm, at least as long as it doesn't get to the drums, because then it will mess the braking up badly. Like this. And then let's fit the brake shoes. And actually, this applies to a Puch Maxi because it's the same brakes. So if you have a Puch, it's exactly the same. These new pads have a quite nice spring that seems to be able to be fitted without doing it before having the pads in place. So I think it's going to be a lot easier. Like that. This is a very easy way to either lose the spring or have a spring stuck in your eye. So it's a good idea to wear some safety goggles when fitting brakes with the spring. Let's fit the other one. Like this. And there we go. The brakes now move nicely. And there is braking material on both shoes, which is also nice. So let's just fit it back on. Like that. And then this. And the nut. Then this wheel. Well, almost. Then this wheel is ready to go back on the bike. Let's take a look at the rear. So this is the rear wheel. And this brakes by pulling the chain backwards using your feet. And there is some pads inside of here, or shoes inside of here that breaks it. Those need to be lubricated, and that is all we are going to try in this video, because I do not have the tool to take this apart. So I hope that we can lubricate it up and make it work better. Well, this would be a lot better to take apart and clean up, because maybe the shoes are actually worn out. But it is breaking. It just needs a lot of force to actually work. And I would also add that I'm not an expert in these kinds of brakes at all. I'm pretty much just trying something today on the rear brakes to make them better. I used BD40 for this right now, and that's not a very good lubricant, because it's actually a petroleum based, so it seems as though it lubricates very good, but the petroleum will evaporate and then it's not lubricating anymore. But it's great at cleaning stuff. So I have just filled the entire hub with it, and I'm now trying to move it as much as possible, and then I'm gonna lube it up with some better grease in a second. Now I'm ready to give it some grease. But I think it's good. It's a lot tighter now than it was before, so I think it's going to work fine. Actually, I'm gonna put the wheels back on the bike and take you back afterwards. So as you could see, the bike is able to stop now. That was only the rear brakes I used. They're actually almost a bit too good at the moment. I think they will bed in, so it's all right. I'd love to take you on a ride, but it's completely dark outside, so you wouldn't be able to see anything. But it works, and I have to remember to close the fuel tap like there. That's a problem, because the first moped I got was a Velo Solex, and I have been driving them for many years now, and they don't have that switching off thing on the fuel, because it's a fuel pump. So I keep on forgetting that. But it works, and it runs so extremely good, this one. It's really fast, and now it also brakes, so that's a good thing on a quick moped. As I said earlier, one of my good friends are most likely taking over this bike for the trip we're going on soon, so I don't think you will be seeing this moped on the channel in the future. But maybe if it breaks down, it will come back. I don't know, I hope. Because I like to work on this bike, it's a lot of fun. Let me show you the bike a bit closer. I also just fitted the seals, which have been off because I did a lot of adjustment to the engine, and it's quite difficult to access this part of the engine with the covers on. You can easily adjust the timing and change timing equipment, but other than that, it's a bit. And I also had a bit of an issue where it rattled like crazy when driving fast, but I think I got it sorted. I haven't really driven it fast right now because it's so dark outside. But this is a Motobecane Mobylette AV44. And the engine is in here. I changed the barrel. I changed the exhaust, which is actually not exactly the right size and is a bit rattly. But it works fine. I put on some Velo Solex tires because I had them lying around. And yeah, the engine is very simple in design. When the revs goes up on the engine, it will engage with this clutch that drives this pulley down here, that drives this big wheel, that drives this chain, that drives this wheel. And on the other side, there is the chain for the bicycle part of this moped, which you use to get it up to speed to start the engine, and also you can actually switch the engine completely off by this one, by turning this one, then you can use it as a bicycle, a very, very, very bad bicycle, but it's nonetheless a bicycle, especially because this does not have any kind of reserve tank, so you have to check your fuel level. And that's also quite difficult because there's no way of checking it other than looking down into here or trying to splash it around and listen. But yeah, so it's a good bike to take on some extra fuel in a little can or something like that. Or just getting used to using the bicycle part. But it's an awesome bike, and I think it's from the 70s. I haven't really checked the VIN number on it yet, but it's an old bike. My friend who are going to buy it would like to change the saddle, maybe for a Puch one, even though it's not a Puch, but the Puch saddle is extremely comfortable. And this is not really. But yeah, it's a nice bike. And now it brakes as well on the rear and on the front. So this will be all for this little video about fixing the brakes on a Mobylette. As I told you earlier, this is the same on a Puch Maxi, also for the rear, in fact, because it's the same braking system as the front on this, with the drum part, not the pedal thingy. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and see you in the next one. I hope to get some more mopeds in the future, but let's see.